channel. Another weekend, another tour. And I'm with Ate Princess. Rachel. And Diane. Refresh also and her mom. Pero wala pa sila dito. So, today is September 20, 2020. And we're in Kuya Jom's crib, Catmon, Cebu, to experience scuba diving for the first time. This is actually my first vlog in Cebu, but you can expect more since Cebu is my hometown. And this is also our first travel since lockdown. That's why we're very excited to experience the underwater world. And tingnan mo, ang busy nila mag-photoshoot. So we're waiting for our instructor since he is preparing the things for us. As for the details, you can experience Discover Scuba Diving for 1,500 pesos only, which includes the rent of the gears and equipment, one dive which takes about 30 to 45 minutes depending on your hour consumption, and photos and video coverage. For the transportation, we got here by private car, but if you're coming from Cebu City, then you could take a bus from North Bus Terminal to Catmon. This is just in the highway, so you can easily find it by ways. And so, we're gonna have our theories in a while, and then we'll see you in the underwater world.
The scuba unit is composed of 5 major parts. First is the mask. The material used for the lens is a tempered glass and with a silicone skirt. Of course, very basic para makakita ta underwater. Next is our cylinder or our tank. What's inside here is not oxygen. This is basically the same air that we breathe here in the surface. Here in the surface, we're not breathing 100% oxygen, okay? So what's in here is 78% nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, and 1% of all the mixture of the air here in the surface, mostly argon. Why not pure O2? It's not pure O2 because pure O2 accumulated with pressure is toxic. In scuba diving, we call that oxygen toxicity. Now, what's inside the cylinder is a high pressure air, no? This is what's inside. Can't breathe through that. So we can't breathe through sa ato ang tank alone. So it is connected to the other major part of our scuba unit, which is called the regulator. It regulates the air. It changes the high pressured air to breathable air. I want you guys to focus here on my right side. I have two hoses and two apparatus that look alike. They have the same purpose. The short one is basically your primary air source. Not all the time, most of the time, you will use this to breathe. Sa atong regulator, naatay purge button. It's sa center. It releases air. We have a secondary regulator. The secondary regulator is also called the octopus. See, this is longer and has a brighter color. That has a purpose. Meaning this is not only for you. If your body is in need of air or signaling you like, I'm out of air, share air. He or she can basically just grab this one and breathe through it. Or if makita nimo siya, pwede ra nimo ihatag. But that's not part of the DSD. We will make sure na wala tayo inana. Kay our air can last quite long, depends sa inyong consumption, but of course, we'll always check on you guys. Aww. The next part, here on my left side. On my left side,
I have a memorization.
There's a high-pressured hose connected to a console. Now, this console is really, really important. This tells us how much air we have left in the surface. As you can see here, it's on 200, no? So 200 bars is the standard full tank. Here, there's a red line. The red line, nasa sa 50, that's the caution zone. Meaning, we need to be on the shallow and ready to end our dive. That doesn't mean na wala natin hangin. Usually, we signal our body, I'm low on air. There's another hose. This is called the inflator hose. It provides air. It is connected to our next major part, which is called the BCD, the buoyancy control device or the buoyancy compensator device. Mauni mo help nato sa atong buoyancy underwater for us to float and for us to sink. I have two buttons here. Two buttons is the inflate button and the deflate button. The one that's closer to you is called the inflate button. This will serve like a life jacket. The next one is the deflate button. Of course, releases air. But there's difference between them. First kanisha, it will work whatever position you're gonna push it. But this one will only work if you position yourself upright, place this above your shoulder, and then push. And just let the water or let physics do the work. So that's basically it. And now, our fins. The fins is really important. Ang gamit sa atong fins for us not to use our hands. This is for propulsion. We use this all the time. We use our legs all the time underwater, and I want you guys to avoid swimming with your hand because it's useless. We are carrying a huge amount of weight. We have our fins, that's enough for us to be propelled underwater. And of course, for us to avoid some accidents. If mag-swim magta sa atong kamot, naay tendency nga makaigota. Let's say ako isang giginhawa, naigalamoy sa akong kilid, matangtang sa akong baba. So now we go to the skills. Underwater, naay times na mufog atong mask. So the first skill that we're going to learn is called the mask clearing. The way we clear it up is of course to put water in and to release the water. So the first thing that I gotta do is I have to look down. Tilt the top part of the mask. Tilt just a little bit and just put just below my eye level. I will put water here and then I inhale. I'll push the top center part and then blow as hard as you can through your nose. The water will just come out here, sa side. So that's how we do it. Since you are wearing contact lens, just try to close your eyes underwater and then, or when you're a man, just below eye level, it will not reach your eyes. Second skill is the regulator clearing. Sometimes dry na kaya itong baba during the dive ba. So sometimes atong tangtangon. Pero if you're, it's your choice ba. Kana si Master Tata, iyahan ang tangtangon, inom na siya tubig gamay.
Para tanay.
The moment nga pagbalik niya balik sa iyahang baba, there's water in between, di ba? So how do we clear that out? There's two methods in clearing this. If you think you have enough air inside your lungs, just blow as hard as you can, just like clearing a snorkel. The water will automatically come out sa vents. The second way is the fridge button method. Then what you're going to do is just to seal this one with your lips, cover this one with your tongue, and then push the fridge button. The water will just push out here. So na itong skill is the regulator recovery. Now there are some times na pag matangtang ang atong regulator, we cannot locate, no? In the books, ingon sila, we have to position ourselves upright. Touch our knees, touch the back of the tank, and then sweep. The hose will just be here sa inyong arm or sa inyong shoulder. And then, you put it back sa inyong baba, and then you clear it in whatever way you want. Blowing or using the purge button. Pero it's never taught sa libro, and it's never restricted to use your eyes. If you can see it, just pun it, and then punita o ibutang sa imong baba. But if you're gonna have a hard time, always remember, your octopus is always on your right side. Pick it up, and then breathe from it. Of course, clear it before you breathe from it. So that's the skills that we're going to do. Katurang tulo. Pero, we're gonna do it in the shallow first. I'll be doing it first. I will signal you, watch me with you. You watch me, and then I will do the skill first. And then when I point at you back, you do the skill after me. Pero we'll just stay like chest deep, and then magluhod lang ta, and then you repeat after me lang. Sunod, of course, di man ta ka story underwater. Atong himuon is hand signals. Very basic lang. Underwater, this is okay. This is not three. This is not money. This is okay. This is not okay. This is going up. So if I see you signaling like this, musaka ta, mundang ta tong dive. So di na ginahanan na. This is okay. This is going up. This is going down. Going sa side or any direction. This is very important. This is problem. So if you have a problem, and point where, balta di ka ka-equalize, say it's a problem, point your ears. Anything kanang maglisod mo, just problem. Anyway, everything can be solved underwater except monetary problems. So, ang atong hiyon na niya, kahiyon mo, pangihi lang, ay lang po, lalibang nito. So, problem, if natay cramps, this is cramps. Yan, key point. Pero if my experience mo, Grams, always remember to be calm, breathe lang, breathe. As long as you're breathing, you're okay. We will be assisting you and just don't go up ahead of us.
Narattal ba? O, saka naman!
There will be a lot of us who's gonna assist you guys and hopefully you'll enjoy the dive. I will give you guys your wetsuit now.
Oh my goodness!
Just chill and then we'll set everything up.
Yes!
Any questions?
Practice na lang.
Kanisa, if you see me doing this, this is me asking how much air you have left. So, you have to look sa imong SPG or submersible pressure gauge. Kaning na sa ubos. If you have 100, you can signal 150 or 100. or this is half tank, so this is 100. Half tank, 50. Half tank, 80. Not 80. Okay? I'm gonna assume na naara kay 50. So that's low on air. So, 5, okay man.
Ah, oo, okay man.
So, if mag 3 mo, kani ang 3 or kani.
Okay, so we're done with the theories, and after this, we're gonna have our practice session para sa equalization.
Okay.
Third na talaga
naka best
namin.
Ay, hindi ako ba? Oh, this is how you manlor. Diba, nasa if na-film niya, kanang nasunog
muna yung nabilin sa manufacturing ba? Ito yung gagawin, pero hindi madaling mag-fog yung mask. Saan yung pagkabawang mo na na siya?
Feel lang. Hindi siya mabuslot kaya tempered mo na siya. So, heated na siya daan.
Lunchtime!
Oi, excuse me!
So ganyan yung initiation pag magbibigay ng certificate sa isang scuba diver. Congratulations!